Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. In the previous session, we discussed about the definition of integration. Okay. In this video, I will give the integrations of some standard functions. Okay. Very first formula. Already we know that in the case of differentiation, derivative of x power n. Already we saw the formula of differentiation of x power n, which is n into x power n minus 1. In the similar way, we are going to discuss about integration of x power n. Everybody knows that the symbol of integration is this one. The function is x power n. So, integration of x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. If n is not equal to minus 1. This formula is valid only when n is not equal to minus 1. Because if n is equal to minus 1, then what happened? If n is equal to minus 1, denominator becomes to 0. Minus 1 plus 1, 0. If denominator is 0, then entire value becomes to infinity, which is undefined. That's why. Okay. How can we get this formula? Very simple. From the definition of integration, in the previous session, already we discussed about the definition. From that definition, simply we understand that derivative and integrations are inverse procedures to each other. Okay. So, find out derivative of this term. Derivative of x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c is equal to. Clearly, this is in the form of x power n formula. So, whose derivative is n plus 1 into x power n plus 1 minus 1 by n plus 1 plus differentiation of constant is 0. Everybody knows that differentiation of a constant number is 0. So, n plus 1 getting cancelled, plus 1 minus 1 getting cancelled. So, simply we get x power n. Okay. We are observing that this is the antiderivative of this term. That's why integration of x power n is equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. Okay. So, if n is equal to minus 1, if n is equal to minus 1, above formula becomes integral x power minus 1 into dx is equal to integration. How can we write x power minus 1? 1 by x into dx. Integration of 1 by x is nothing but log mod x to the base e plus c. Because already we know that differentiation of this term is, what is the derivative of log mod x to the base e? We know that 1 by x, differentiation of constant is 0. That's why you will get 1 by x. So, this is the derivative for this function and this is the antiderivative for this function. So, if you find integration of this function, you will get this one. Okay. Third, actually this first formula is very important. So, in many problems, we can apply this formula. For example, we have to find out integration of x power 2 by 3. Integration of x power 2 by 3. This is in the form of x power n. So, how can we write the formula? X power n plus 1. What is n value? 2 by 3. So, 2 by 3 plus 1 by 2 by 3 plus 1 plus c. After completion of integration, we should add a constant c. This is called constant of integration, otherwise parameter. Okay. Is equal to 2 plus 3. By taking the LCM, 2 plus 3 which is 5. So, you will get x power 5 by 3 by 5 by 3 plus c. You can write as 3 into x power 5 by 3 by 5 plus c. So, that's why this formula is very important. In many problems, we can apply this formula. So, don't forget this formula. If n is equal to minus 1 in this formula, then this term becomes 1 by x. Integration of 1 by x is log x. Because derivative of log x is 1 by x. That's why. Now, by using this formula, you will get some more results. integral x dx. Already we know that derivative of x is 1. Similarly, we are going to find out the integration of x now. So integration of x is, clearly this is in the form of x power n. Okay. What is the n value? 1. N is equal to 1. So you will get x power 1 plus 1. X square by 2 plus c. You can also write one more result. Integral x square dx is equal to x cube by 3 plus c. Because compare this x square with x power n. You have n is equal to 2 here. So x power 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1, which is x cube by 3. Similarly, you can find out the remaining terms also, like integral x power 4. Sorry, integral x cube. What is integral x cube? X power 4 by 4. What is integral x power 4? X power 5 by 5. That's why. Okay. Maybe n is also a rational number, like p by q form. Okay. If take this one, integral 1 by x square, integral 1 by x square, you can write this one as integral x power minus 2 into dx. This formula is applicable in all cases except n is equal to minus 1. Here n is equal to minus 2. So you will get x power minus 2 plus 1 by minus 2 plus 1 plus c. That is equal to x power minus 1 by minus 1 plus c. This is equal to minus 1 by x plus c. X power, take this x power minus 1 to denominator. So you will get minus 1 by x plus c. So simply you can write as integral 1 by x square is nothing but minus 1 by x plus c. That's why this formula is very, very important here. Next formula is exponential function. Exponential function is nothing but e power x. The name of e power x is exponential function. Okay. Already we know that derivative of an exponential function is itself. That's why if you find out integration of this function, you will get the similar function. So integration of e power x is also itself. After completion of integration, don't forget adding constant c. This constant c is called constant of integration, otherwise parameter. Okay. A power x is known as algebraic function. So integration of a power x is a power x by log a plus c. In the case of differentiation, we know that derivative of a power x is a power x into log a. Okay. If you find out integration of this term, you will get a power x by log a. Okay. For example, find out differentiation of this term, you will get a power x. That's all. Next, integral 1 dx. In the case of differentiation of 1, it is 0, but in the case of integration, integral 1 can be written as x power 0. So this is in the form of integral x power n, which is first formula of integrations. X power n plus 1 by n plus 1. We know that this formula is valid for all values of n except n is equal to minus 1, but here n is equal to 0. You can compare with x power n, the power n is 0. That's why you will get x power 0 plus 1 by 0 plus 1. So 0 plus 1 is nothing but x by 1. Simply it is x. So integral 1 dx is nothing but simply you can read as x plus c. Integral 1 dx is simply x plus c. Now it's time for integrations of trigonometric functions. Before writing the formula on integrations of trigonometric functions, see the formula and differentiation. What is the derivative of sine x cos x? Derivative of cos x is equal to minus sine x. Derivative of tan x is equal to secant square x. Derivative of cosecant x is equal to minus cosecant x into cot x. First see this four formula. Please see this one. If we find differentiation of cos x, we are getting minus sin x. If we take integration of sin x, you will get minus cos x. Integration of sin x is equal to minus cos x. Integration is completed. That's why add c. Already from the definition of integration, we should understand that derivative and integrations are inverse processes to each other. It means that suppose we are finding differentiation of this function, we are getting this one. So reversely, if you get integration of this function, you will get cos x, but there is a negative sign. That's why you will get minus cos x. Okay, don't forget this thing. Integration of cos x. Okay, please see the first formula in the differentiation. If we find derivative of sin x, you will get cos x. That's why if we find integration of cos x, you will get sin x. Simple, because differentiation and integrations are reciprocal to each other. Okay, 11th one. Please see this order. If we find differentiation of tan x, we are getting secant square x. So reversely, if we find out integral secant square x, you will get tan x. Integral secant square x dx is equal to tan x plus c. And formula number 12. See this one. If we find differentiation of cosecant x, you are getting cosecant x into cot x. If we find integration of cosecant x into cot x, you will get cosecant x, but negative sign is there. That's why result is minus cosecant x. So the next formula is integral cosecant x into cot x dx is equal to minus cosecant x. After completion of integration, we should add constant c. Next one, integral secant x into tan x is equal to secant x plus c, because already we know that derivative of secant x is equal to secant x into tan x. Please try to remember this formula in differentiation. Already we know that derivative of secant x is equal to secant x into tan x. Okay, but we know that derivative and integrations are inverse processes to each other. That's why if you find integration of this function, you will get this function. So that's why we are writing secant x. Integration is completed. That's why we should add constant c. Whenever we are finding the integration of a function, after writing the integration, we should add the constant c. Don't forget to add constant c after completion of integration, which is very, very important. Okay. Here c is called, this is not only constant, this is a parameter, otherwise integral constant. Okay. Finally, in the differentiation, we know that differentiation of cot x is equal to minus cosecant square x. So if you are finding integration of this term, you will get minus cot x. So integral cosecant square x dx is equal to minus cot x plus c. Okay, once again, I will revise the formula and trigonometry briefly. Look at this. Integral sin x is minus cos x plus c. Integral cos x is sin x plus c. Don't forget one thing. In the case of differentiation, you will get negative sign for cos. Derivative of cos x is minus sin x. But in the case of integration, integration sign get minus cos x. Don't forget it. Okay, so integral secant square x is tan x plus c. Integral cosecant x cot x is equal to minus cosecant x plus c. Integral secant x into tan x is equal to secant x plus c. Integral cosecant square x dx is equal to minus cot x plus c. Don't forget one thing. We are all getting this all standard formula by using the differentiation only, because differentiation and integrations are inverse processes to each other. Don't forget this thing. Okay. Okay, now we are going to discuss about the integrations on hyperbolic functions. Integral sine hx. Integral sine hx is equal to, in the case of trigonometry, integration of sine x is minus cos x, but the specialty of sine hx is it becomes positive. Cos hx plus c. Okay, next one. Integral cos hx dx is equal to sin hx. Already we know that. What is the derivative of sin hx? Cos hx. So if you find the integration of this term, you will get sin hx. That's why you will get this term. So the second one is derivative of cos hx. Derivative of cos hx is equal to sin hx. That's why if you find integration of sin hx, you will get cos hx. Okay. In order, sin hx, cos hx, after that, c in trigonometry. You will get integral secant h square x. Integral secant h square x is equal to tan hx plus c. Okay. In order, next formula is integral cosecant hx into cot hx dx is equal to minus cosecant hx plus c. Next, integral secant hx into tan hx dx. In the case of trigonometry, you will get positive of secant x, but in the case of hyperbolic, it is negative. Next, integral cosecant h square x dx, it is also negative, minus cot hx plus c. Now it's time for formula on inverse trigonometric functions. So once remember the formula and differentiation. D by dx of sine inverse x, d by dx of sine inverse x, which is equal to 1 by root over 1 minus x square. So d by dx of cos inverse x minus 1 by root over 1 minus x square. So consider this one. If we find derivative of sin inverse x, we are getting 1 by root over 1 minus x square. So reversely, if you find integration of this term, you will get sin inverse x. Very, very important formula. Integral 1 by root over 1 minus x square dx is equal to sin inverse x plus c. Sin inverse x plus c. Okay. So in the second one also, if you find the integration of this term, you will get cos inverse x, but minus is there. If you take this minus to this side, you will get this one, minus cos inverse x plus c. So there are two formulae for this one. Integral 1 by root over 1 minus x square dx is equal to sin inverse x plus c, otherwise minus cos inverse x plus. Okay, now we know that d by dx of tan inverse x is equal to 1 by 1 plus x square. So reversely, if you take the integration of this term, you will get tan inverse x. This is the next one. Very, very important formula. Integral 1 by 1 plus x square dx is equal to tan inverse x plus c. Of course, we have another formula also. Derivative of cot inverse x is equal to minus 1 by 1 plus x square. So if you take the integration of this term, you will get a similar function, but there is negative sign. That's why we have another formula for the same integral, which is minus cot inverse x plus c. Minus cot inverse x plus c. Also, we have another one. Differentiation of secant x, which is equal to 1 by mod x into root over x square minus 1. If you find derivative of secant inverse x, you will get this one. So reversely, if you find integration of this term, you will get secant inverse x. So integration of 1 by mod x into root over x square minus 1 dx is equal to secant inverse x plus c. Otherwise, we have another one, which is minus cosecant inverse x plus c. Okay. Similarly, we can write the formula on integrations which are on inverse hyperbolic functions. Integral 1 by root over 1 plus x square is equal to sin h inverse x plus c, because already we know that differentiation of this term is this one. Integral 1 by root over x square minus 1 is equal to cos h inverse of x plus c. Connection between the differentiation and integration. Differentiation and integrations are inverse processes to each other. That is the connection between differentiation and integration. So, from this formula, internally we conclude that for the integration knowledge, knowledge of differentiation is mandatory. If you do not know about the differentiation, integrations becomes very difficult. So, first learn differentiation, which is very, very important thing. And one more important point is, for our higher studies, differentiation and integration knowledge is very, very important. Okay, you can't escape from these two topics. Okay, if you studied higher studies like BTEC, BSc Max, MSc Max, etc., then knowledge of integration and differentiation is very, very important. Okay, I hope you are all understand today's topic. In the next video, I will start the exercise problems, okay, which are depends upon basic formula. Okay, if you practice this basic formula, then only you are able to understand the problems on exercises. Okay, thank you very much. See you to next video.